Welcome to the ThinkCell tutorials. This video shows you how to build line charts, including profile charts, area charts, area 100% charts, and combination charts with ThinkCell. We will cover the following topics in this order. First, we will have a look at the line chart as the quintessential chart type from this family of charts, and explain some basic concepts like customizing lines, markers, point labels, axes, and interpolation, which apply to all of them. Then, we will turn to the other individual chart types, namely profile chart, area chart, area 100% chart, and finally combination chart. The line chart uses lines to connect data points belonging to the same series, usually to visualize a trend in data over time intervals. To insert a line chart into your presentation, go to the ThinkCell tab in the PowerPoint ribbon, open the Elements menu, and move your mouse to the line icon. The small arrows around it offer you different options for the orientation of the chart. Let's say you would like to use a traditional, non-flipped line chart in your presentation. Click the top arrow. The orange insertion frame appears on the slide. Click once to insert the chart at your preferred position. You may resize the default chart according to your needs after insertion. Alternatively, you can insert the chart in a customized size by clicking and holding down your mouse button and dragging the orange insertion frame until you are happy with its size. Release the mouse to insert the chart. The data sheet opens automatically and you can type in or copy-paste your data. The chart is updated automatically while you enter your values in text. If the data sheet has been closed, you can always bring it back by double-clicking on the white space of the chart. The default chart uses lines without markers or point labels. The y-axis is displayed on the left, and series labels are shown on the right-hand side. But you can always customize the format and look of your line chart. Let's see how this is done. Left-click on the chart to open the floating toolbar. Here, you can choose between different line schemes in the drop-down menu. Alternatively, you can left-click on one of the lines to change them individually in terms of their line style and color. You may also customize the markers with regard to shape, size, and color by left-clicking onto the line and picking your preferred option from the respective drop-down menu. The same can be done for individual markers. To add point labels to your line chart, right-click onto the chart and choose Add Point Labels from the context menu. You can format the label's content via the floating toolbar. Again, you may also add or delete labels for the whole data series or individual data points. If you prefer a smoother appearance of the lines in your chart, right-click on the respective line or multi-selection of lines and choose Set to Smooth Line from the context menu. You may also customize the axes of your chart, for instance by changing the placement of the axis, switching between category and date axis, adding a second y-axis, or axis break. For details on how to do this, please watch our tutorial video on Chart Annotations and Decorations Part 2. Let's assume that there are missing values in the data for your line chart. By default, ThinkCell interpolates the missing values to display an uninterrupted line in your chart. To disable interpolation, right-click onto the respective line or multi-selection of lines, and pick Do Not Interpolate from the context menu. A special case of the line chart is the profile chart. To insert one, open the Elements menu, hover your mouse over the line chart icon, and click the arrow to the right. Click again to place it on the slide, or hold and drag to adjust the size for insertion. Typically, a profile chart lists specific topic areas in the category labels. For example, for a company or product comparison. Let's say you would like to compare three companies on the basis of evaluation data by their employees, and this data is stored in an Excel sheet. Select the data range in Excel, open the Link to PowerPoint menu, and click on to existing element. In PowerPoint, click onto the chart once. It is now linked to your Excel data. To fine-tune the look of your profile chart, adjust the tick mark spacing by selecting the value axis and dragging the small white circle until you're satisfied with the spacing. Release the mouse button. Then click on the axis, hold down your mouse button, and drag the axis upwards. A gap between the lines and the axis appears. Let go of the mouse button. Now you are done. An area chart can be thought of as a stacked line chart, with the data points representing the sum of the values in the categories rather than the individual values. To insert an area chart, open the Elements menu and select Area. Click and hold down your mouse button and drag the orange insertion frame to the desired size. Release the mouse button. Type or paste your data into the data sheet and adjust the chart to your needs. As with a line chart, point labels are not displayed by default, but can be added via the right-click context menu. Here, you may also add total labels to your area chart. The Area 100% chart is a variant of the area chart, with the sum of all values in a category typically representing 100%. To insert an Area 100% chart, open the Elements menu, pick Area 100%, position the insertion frame on the slide, and click once. Enter your data and customize the chart as needed. Finally, let's look at the combination chart, which combines line and column segments in a single chart. To insert a combination chart into your presentation, open the Elements menu, click onto the combination icon, and then click again to place the chart on the slide. As the line and the stacked segments in a combination chart are often on different scales, the default combination chart is inserted with a second y-axis and the line series set to the right y-axis. In the internal datasheet of the default chart, the topmost series row is represented as a line in the chart, whereas the following rows are displayed as stacked columns. But you are free to change any line series into a column series and vice versa, as well as change their association with the axes. We will look at how to do this in a moment. First, let's stick to the given structure and enter some data. For example, the number of online ads in the first series and that of page clicks in the second, showing their correlation over a period of 6 months. Fine-tune the look of your chart according to your needs. Another way to add a combination chart into your presentation is to convert a line chart or a stacked column chart. Let's say you have data for EBIT and EBIT margin in different series in an Excel sheet. Select the data range, open the Link to PowerPoint menu, and select Stacked. Place the chart in PowerPoint by clicking onto the slide once. A stacked column chart is inserted in which the EBIT margin series, whose values are much, much lower, is displayed on top of the EBIT series. Now turn the EBIT margin series into a line series by hovering your mouse over one of its segments and left-clicking once to open the floating toolbar. Click on the line icon from the chart type control to convert the series. As both the stacked and the line series are still on the same scale, let's add two y-axes to the chart. Right-click onto the chart and select Add Y-axis from the context menu. Right-click again and pick Add Second Y-axis. Now, right-click on the line and choose Set to Right Axis to give the series its own scale. That's it. You have turned a stacked chart into a combination chart. Following these steps, you may of course also turn a line chart into a combination chart. Customize the size and look of your chart to your liking, for example by changing the fill and line colors, adjusting the axes, and adding access titles. That's it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please visit our website for more ThinkCell tutorials.